Hey, let's talk about electrophilic aromatic substitution. And so there are five general types that we'll talk about here that are listed on the left, and they all share a common mechanism where we form an electrophile, usually with a formal charge of plus one, that is so unstable it can cause the benzene ring that is stable to open up, grab that electrophile, forming an unstable intermediate where one of the carbons receives the electrophile, the other the plus charge, and then we form our substitution product by substituting the electrophile for the hydrogen that is already in position here on the ring. Okay, so we do that, grab that hydrogen, reform the aromatic ring, and we've got our substitution. Very good reaction. And so the only difference is, how do we form the electrophile? Well, with halogenation, the electrophile forms when molecular bromine or chlorine, so this could be Cl2, FeCl3 to form a chlorobenzene, and we're going to bring our catalyst near, FeBr3. A lone pair on bromine is going to attach to that Lewis acid catalyst, and we are going to form our activated species here. Formal charge plus one on the Lewis structure, significant amount of positive charge is actually forming on this bromine as well. FeBr3, formal charge negative one on iron, and so we are ready to go. So we bring our activated complex here near the benzene ring. Mechanistically, we open up. Lone pair goes on to bromine. And we form our intermediate. This time we'll show it down here. So there's the bromine, positive charge there. Balance that equation, we get FeBr4, floats away, we never see it again. A base of some sorts, whether it's solvent or the FeBr4, comes in, returns aromaticity, and we get our substitution. With nitration, we form the electrophile a little bit different way. So we've got a concoction here of nitric acid, which we're going to show highlighting this bond, and sulfuric acid. We're going to show highlighting one of the OH bonds of sulfuric acid. We're going to take two strong acids, one stronger than the other. Sulfuric is stronger, so we're going to protonate this oxygen, forming a good leaving group. So if you permit me here, we'll form the good leaving group, water, which then leaves, forming our nitronium ion. So there's our E plus, our electrophile. We add that mechanistically to our benzene ring. We open up, form that intermediate. Base from solution. Doesn't have to be a strong base, could be a very weak base, because the benefit of reforming that aromatic ring is so great. Sulfonation is conceptually similar to nitration. We're going to take two sulfuric acid molecules and do the same type treatment. In equilibrium, one is going to protonate the other, form that good leaving group in water, stable leaving group, can leave, forming our sulfonium ion here that then adds to the benzene ring. So these are converging mechanisms. Then again, deprotonate to reform aromaticity in the ring, and we get our substitution. So then let's attach some carbon groups to the ring here with the Friedel-Crafts reaction. So we can do this. The alkylation takes an alkyl chloride with aluminum chloride catalyst and water as a workup step at the end. The only thing we have to remember is that these alkylations can rearrange if we try to form a primary or less stable carbocation. So if we can form a more stable carbocation, we must. And so that happens when we form the electrophile in the first step. So let's look at this. Bring our catalyst nearby. So we attach. Forming these formal charges on aluminum and chlorine. And so then, rather than leaving to form a primary carbocation here, we do a hydride shift to help that complex break apart, and we instead form a secondary carbocation. So we never actually invoke the primary carbocation here. We've got our electrophile. We've rearranged, and so now we open the ring as normal. In our mechanisms, we've seen this over and over. We deprotonate, and we get our Friedel-Crafts alkylation substitution there. Now, to prevent those rearrangements from occurring, we can use the Friedel-Crafts acylation. And so let's see that. There we go. So Friedel-Crafts acylation. And we use an acyl halide. Okay, and so then when we're forming our electrophile, we'll show it over here like we have been doing. Bring our catalyst close. Attach. Formal charge -1 + 1, and then this leaves with a little bit of assistance from the anomeric lone pair here. And we get our acylium ion. Is our electrophile, and it is in resonance with this species. Okay, so the resonance would occur like this. And so we can consider either one being attacked. This version satisfies the octet rule, so I'll show that. We attack the electrophile intermediate forms, base from solution, deprotonates, and we have our acyl substituted benzene. We can go on to perform a Wolff-Kishner reduction or Clemmensen or Mazzingo reaction to reduce that if we desire an alkyl group in that position.